Hola guys and girls, and welcome to the draft analysis video for the UPBA. Yes, I'm back in an English-speaking league again, so all of you who follow me for my English drafting content, or content in general, finally can enjoy some drafting content again. And yeah, as you can see from the graphic again, you already see the first pick right here. I'm not going to go too much detail right now, first a short introductory words to the league. As you can see on the bottom right there, we do have quite a lot of coaches in this league, a total of 20, so the draft was definitely going to be not an easy one, since with 20 coaches, it's like, at the beginning you have all the options you want, but the more rounds you go, you will see that like most of the good ones are already gone, and you have to start to make compromises, and of course the probability of being sniped is yeah, very high. The good thing was, as you can see in the graphic down below, I was in the 4th spot in the drafting position. So I could at least guarantee a very nice, strong, good round 1 pick. And after that have like kind of a wheel. So I think in the first 4 to 5 spots you can still call it a wheel. Other than that, it depends on the size of the league. But with 20 coaches, with being the 4th one, especially very nice. So that means I can pick 1, have to wait a long time. Pick 2 most of the time, have to wait a long time. Pick 2 most of the time, and so on and so on. So that will definitely did affect my drafting strategy, or not really my strategy, but my drafting choices, because with 20 coaches, like I'm not a fan either way of making like whole draft plans, like picking all these slots right here. But I rather have like core ideas. Like I want to draft like, of course I want to draft my cores, and I think what can I fit there, what's still left. That's what how I approach this draft as well. As you can see, my first pick is a dragon. So the first 3 mons I picked actually are my fairy dragon steel core, and after that I would be looking to finish off my fire dragon grass core. Then I want hazards. I want a grounded poison type. I want a dark type. So these are like all the things I want to have. But definitely fairy dragon steel is what I want first, because there are not that many dragons around, first of all, and fairies, and there are not that many great fairies you really want. Steel type is a bit easier, but I think dragon fairy are definitely the two big ones, which do go away quickly. If you want to have strong good ones, of course you can always like settle for something you don't want, but I think with my cores, which I want to bring to most of my games, I do want to have the most quality options, and that's how I approach this draft. And that's it, as you can see, as my first pick always has to be like the mon which my opponent sees, and they're like, crap, what do I have for this mon, what do I do? And I think with Zygarde, I definitely got that one. It's banned in most other leagues. It costs 18 points. Oh, by the way, it was a pointed draft. 18 points actually is the highest points you have to pay for a mon, potentially. There's my cursor the whole time on screen. I'm sorry for that. And yeah, we have a budget of 120 points. That's why on the top right, you can see that I have 102 points left. But yeah, I would have a big, big threat on my team turn 1. It is a dragon as well. Already ground type as well. So I got my electric immunity checked, and like I said, I want to build this fairy dragon steel core, and Zygarde is a nice option. With 1000 arrows, you only need 1 attacking move. There's no immunity to that. A few mons which resist that, which are only grass types. And other than that, you can just put anything else there you want. There's so much utility in to that. You can put extreme speed if you want priority. You can set up options in coil and dragon dance. You can put some other coverage you want, put there, toxic, glare, substitute. A lot of options which Zygarde can run just by having 1000 arrows. 1000 arrows is the defining factor of this mon. Zygarde itself has good stats, like decent stats, not very strong but very bulky. But 1000 arrows is what makes this mon so broken, because you just need that. And then you're already, boom, I have my coverage, I have my moves. Now just see what I can fill in to beat the rest of the team. So yeah, I'm definitely a big fan of that. It's the first time me using it, so I'm definitely excited for that. But yeah, that is my first mon. And then after a long waiting time, I could pick my second one, which is my, god damn it doesn't work like this, it seems. I have to click, there we go, Sylveon. Because as I mentioned, fairies and dragons are the ones that run out first, so I do want to win a finish off in my fairy dragon steel core. I do want a good strong fairy, and at this point I think I could have chosen Togekiss as well, but I do not, even though boots are a thing, I do not want the rocks weakness on my fairy, because I think the fairy has to switch into a lot of moves. Because that's good resistances to a lot of things which are usually offensively very threatening. So that's why I decided to with Silver in here, which is a very nice fairy. It's a good value pick at 13 points as well. Like I wouldn't be surprised if it's like at 14 points or something like that. But yeah, Wish Passer, got Mystical Fire this gen, so yeah, it is my fairy. It's my bulky fairy, what can I say? It's offensively can be pretty strong as well. Of course it's not really fast enough to beat Sweeper. But with Hyper Voice, Mystical Fire, Psyshock, Baton Pass, it has like a nice set for Specs variant as well. And other than that, of course, it's Cleric, Wish, Heal Bell, all the good stuff which all the evolutions get. And yeah, that's it for you. Not really too much to talk about, barring that, yeah, it's my fairy. It does fairy things. That's what Sylvan is here for. And then next up, we go with my Steel type, which probably is already a great core. Once I got this third mon, I was already very happy with my draft, because I think, okay, nice, this is like perfect. Perfect, like stat-wise, nice synergy, typing-wise, nice synergy, because obviously Phaedra's Steel, but the next one is gonna be Skarmory. Skarmory, one of my favorite Steel types, just because, for one, it's fast, it's super bulky on the physical side, which means you can, if you want to run more Spidef, invest a lot in Spidef and still be physically bulky, gets both Hazards, Stealth Rocks, and Spikes, and of course had removal in Defog. And in general, with Sylveon and Zygarde, it's a very nice combination. Zygarde already resists both of the weaknesses of, or it's even immune to Electric as well, with the ground typing, and of course Skarmory, very high physical defense, Sylveon, very high specialty defense. So together they build like a very nice synergistic core already, and I'm a very big fan of this. I got my hazard removal covered, I got my hazards covered. Like, these three mons just give me so much already in the team that when I got Skarmory, I was okay, doesn't matter what I get now, my draft is always going to be cool. And yeah, that's why I'm very happy I got Skarmory. But like I already mentioned, what I want in this draft is build my cores as quickly as possible. So what I need next, of course, is my fire, water, grass core. So what I need is a water type, I need a grass type, and I need a fire type. So what I decided to get next is my water type. And arguably, I think I got it a bit too early. I probably could have gotten that later, but this was one of the mons when you're... Like, that's what you always do first when you enter a league. You look at what is the point system, what is the tier system. What do I think is undervalued? What I think is what should have been higher. And don't say anything, just draft it later on the draft. That's what I like to do, and that's, for me, was Gastrodrome with just 7 points. I think it was a very high value pick, especially since Hand Power Grass is not a thing anymore. So all these 4 types weakness mods are, of course, buffed, and I think Gastrodrome is a very nice bulky water type. Of course, it's a secondary ground type with Zygarde, so I'm already stacked on that. So I have to diverse my timings a little bit more with my future picks. But I like Gastrodrome a lot just because it's like so undervalued. I need the bulky water, and I already knew, okay, if my bulky water is going to be Gastrodon. And at this point in the draft, I was fearing, looking at some other drafts, they might go for that, because especially if they have like the same opinion and me, and thinking like that this is a very undervalued mon. So I was a bit scared of that. In retrospective, I probably could have gotten that later as well, but I'm still happy I got it here. So yeah, Gastrodon is my pick here. Nice recovery in Recover, obviously, a library recovery there. Very bulky on both sides, potentially. It's called Earthquake, Earth Power. You know that, you know what Gastrodon does. It's just annoying and bulky, and yeah, it's a pain for the opponent. So next up, I first thinking like, what do I get next? I want my fire type next, I want my grass type next. There's a lot of mons I still want in my draft. Now thinking, okay, what do I get here? Because I picked Gastrodon, and I was immediately thinking, okay, what, how do I continue from here? And I was like very struggling to find out what my best option could be. But then it hit me, like a very nice thing hit me. Gastrodon, 4 times weak to grass. Only resistance to 1000 arrows, it's grass. Zygarde. So grass types are very likely to come versus my team. Like, my opponent wants to bring the grass type versus my team due to Gastrodon and due to Zygarde. So I was thinking, okay, I need a mon which feeds on grass types. Which, like, if it's a grass type in front of it, this thing gets an opportunity to just destroy it, to set up, like in some form or fashion, can get an advantage out of having grass type in front of it. And I was looking at the mons, and I saw one mon which I never drafted before, which exactly fit that role. And I thought, oh damn, that's such a perfect fit. I definitely want that mon. I did got it. My next mon is Volcarona. It is my fire type for my fire, water, grass core, so I got that covered already. It is my second S pick, like I think like the mons 16, 17, and 18 points. Like, these are the quote unquote S tier, I think. You can only draft 2 of them, so for me that's Volcarona and Zygarde, so the other ones up there are already gone for me. But Volcarona is an awesome setup mon. With Zygarde and Volcarona, my setup potential for the opponent is already huge. They always have to like run some kind of berry, some kind of surprising scarfer, a sash maybe, if I can get rid of hazards or something like that. Because otherwise, I just get a Drang Dance coil up with Zygarde, I get a Quiver Dance up with Volcarona, and just go through the team. And Volcarona, like I already mentioned, since I do force the opponent to bring that grass type, barring against something like Rock Slide or Shenanigans, like Tangrowth for example, It's just free setup for Melbourne Corona. The 4x Rock's weakness is with Boots, of course, already covered. It kind of forces you to run Boots on Corona every single time, but it's not really something you... like, some restriction on Volcarona, it's more like a benefit, because Volboost is just so good on Volcarona, you're never gonna run a different item, which kind of limits it. But on the other hand, it is, of course, a buff in the end. Like, in total, it is a buff, and of course, you can play some nice mind games with the opponent, because the opponent, of course, aren't gonna be expecting me having boots on Volcarona as well. So I can maybe get a big surprise by them by running a different item one time. But for that, of course, I need to make sure to have the hazards broken, otherwise, Volcarona doesn't have that many setup opportunities if it's already at half health. But yeah, that was the idea behind Volcarona. It gives me, of course, a nice fire type, very strong one, and a Pokemon which can, basically advantage of all these grass types which are coming. But yeah, now I need myself, I'm still missing a grass type. I was looking at a few. Of course, now we're getting into territory round 6. Now we're getting into the territory where you're like, you're not gonna get your favorite option. You're gonna have to settle for something which is still left. And that was for me the case here as well. Was definitely going into draft, not my first option of a grass type, whereas some others I preferred, but they were already gone at this point, so I decided to go, oh, never mind me, I don't get my grass type here, I get Nidalego. Ah, true, because of the wheel thing. If you look at it, Zygarde was my first pick, then Sylveon Skarmory was my wheel, Gastrodon and Volcarona was my wheel, and now I decided to get this first because of a grass type I can get next, because I knew the three after me have the grass type already, so I'm not gonna get sniped of that. That's why I decided to go with Nidalego first. But the... okay, let's take it from here. The grass type, that's also what I'm most thinking about in this wheel. So that's why I got into this mode right here, talking about my grass type. So, but once I decide for a grass type, I think, okay, what else do I want in my next few following picks? And of course, what I'm still missing was a grounded poison type. That's what Nidalego fits, for example. And what I'm missing is more hazards, because even though I have two ground types, none of them get Staffrock, and I definitely don't want to have Skarmory be my only Staffrock and my only hazard setter in the game. So I was looking, okay, what is like fits most of these things? I want a grass type, I want a rocker, I want a poison ground, grounded poison type, and what combination of mons fits that role the most? And I decided there to go with Nidalego. Nidalego, one of my favorite mons from Gen 6. So very big fan to drafting that again, especially in draft format. In my first, I don't know which GBA season it was, but I drafted that and Fancy had definitely put in the work. At this time, he actually got another boost this time due to, of course, Hippo Ground being gone, but that was never a factor because Nidalego has very insane speed F. But Meteor Beam. Meteor Beam is a very nice option on Nidalego since you can give it, Nidalego has the option to have this test distributed in the way that the Beast Boost boosts the speed or the special attack. Or potentially Spadef as well, if you want to, but mostly it's going to be Spatak or the Speed. And if you can get the Meteor Beam Special Attack boost, and then get a Speed boost because you get a kill most likely with Meteor Beam, because it's a +1 very strong rock move, you get a Speed boost as well, and then you're set up to sweep. And yeah, that's just another sweeping option on my team with Nidalego. And on the support side of things, of course, he is a rocker, he is a Toxic Spiker, and he's a grounded poison type, so I can get Absorb Poison type. Toxic Spikes, that's the word. Toxic Spikes myself. And yeah, that's why I got it right here. And now, what I talked about earlier, of course, we talk about our grass type, and it's gonna be Decidueye. Because what else I was missing is, if you look, I already have 6 mons drafted, but only one hazard remover in Skarmory. I definitely want another defogger, so I want to have grass type, which can remove hazards, since I decided on Nidalego. And there are only a few left of them, and in the end, I decided to go with Decidueye. Gives me a ghost type as well, so it is a spin blocker too. So if I start with hazard stack with spikes or toxic spikes or something like that, Decidueye is there to stop the spin and yeah, just allow my hazards to stay. And other than that, I like the old design wise a lot. In Draft League, I had him once before where he didn't impress me too much, but I think I can make him definitely work better this time. He can go special physical. He's sadly, like, usually you want your core, like if I want a grass coat, to be at least a bit more bulky than Decidueye actually is. He has rapid recovery in Roost, very easy recovery there, not weather dependent like Synthesis, like for most grass types. But he's not that bulky, especially not on the physical side. Special side is good, but physical side is not as bulky as you would want. It's not that he's super frail, but for my grass types, I usually like to have them more bulky. And that's why I struggled with Decidueye before. But yeah, let's see how he can perform this time with him. Because, yeah, I have him, and I like the owl. I'm a big fan of owls. I like the ghost grass typing. I like Spirit Shackle. It gets Poltergeist this gen as well, so very high-powered physical ghost attack, which is pretty nice. And, yeah, that's Decidueye. Next up, now I got my two cores, and actually I don't remember what I drafted next, so I know which mons I have, but I don't know the order from here. So, because now I got my two cores, I got basically all the things covered I want for now. I still want a dark type that's left. I need to kind of fix my speed tiers a little bit, because that's what I always do with my last few picks, is like, now I have to look at like secondary things you want in the draft. And yeah, so let's see actually what order I drafted them, because I actually don't remember, because the draft was quite a while ago. So yeah, let's go. Next pick is Jolteon, and there we go, fixing speed tiers. My next wheel is going to be about fixing speed tiers, so my next one is Jolteon. I was missing Electro-type as well, and Jolteon of course gives me that big 130 speed tier, which yeah, just makes him very quick. Of course, coverage-wise, he is limited. He got Weather Ball this gen, which is a thing if you have Weather. I don't have Weather, but my opponent has. I can get some nice coverage there. And he has another electric immunity, so I actually have three electric immunities now. So electric types are versus my draft are probably not that effective, which helps Skarmory quite a lot. But yeah, Jolteon, it's only 5 points. It's not the best electric type, like definitely mainly because of the coverage problems it has. But it is very quickly, and like I said, in a big draft as this, especially now that we are like in the latter half of the draft, you have to settle for some things, and Jolteon ticked my box in electric type, and definitely what more important was ticked my box in being like a very high speed tier, which I still needed. And I definitely need a speed tier now between, because right now Neolego, and then we jump to Jolteon, so I definitely need a mon in between that. And yeah, like I mentioned in these last few picks, I only have a few things I want to do still with my draft, and one is fixing speed tier, so that's definitely a gap I have to fill, which I'm gonna do with my next mon, because right here I do get Alolan Persian, which does tick the box as well for my dark type, which is still missing, because you always want to have all immunities possible. You want to have a ghost type for fighting normal immunity, you want a dark immunity, you want a steel type for poison immunities, like you want to have all the immunities possible, so the opponent can potentially not spam move and be a bit more yeah, careful with their scarf, if they have like scarf fighting type, scarf fighting type, whatever they have. But yeah, Persian, very nice dark type. It's a support mon, like it's definitely more of a support mon. It's not gonna really sweep my opponent or do much else. It is very bulky on the physical side due to the fluffy, barring it the moves don't touch it. But it's very quick, has very nice support, like I mentioned, in Party Shot, Taunt, Foul Play, Thunder Wave. Lots of things this thing can do to allow my mons to set up. And the main thing I drafted this thing are the two things, of course, speed tiers, because 115 is right between the 130 and the 103 of Neolego, I think. And of course, dark type, because I want my immunities. And yeah, now for my last three picks. What I'm looking for in my last three picks. So what I'm looking for, preferably, are just the typings I'm missing at this point, which are, I think, I'm missing fighting type. I'm missing a normal type, which is not that important, but preferably you do want a normal type as well, because why not? It's ghost immunity, like I already said, you do want all your immunities. What am I missing as well? Rock type I have my cores. Are these the only two typings I'm missing at this point? I think so. But what else I do want is ground immunity. Because if you look at my thing, draft, my only ground immunity I have at this point is Skarmory, which you definitely do want more, especially if you have monsters like Neolego, which are very weak to ground. I do want more hazard setup, because only Neolego and Skarmory is not enough at least, so I at least want another rocker. And what else would I want at this point? I mean, that's really like all the big stuff I want. Like I want a fighting type, I want a normal type, and I want a ground immunity and a stealth rocker. These are the things I would definitely look right here in my draft. And let's see what I got next. Next I got Uxie. Okay, there we go. Another rocker and a ground immunity in Uxie. And one big point why I wanted Uxie over Mesprit, because Mesprit was at this point in the draft as well. I'm a big fan of Mesprit. I usually like Mesprit more than Uxie. Uxie is more expensive as well. Mesprit would have been only 8 points. But the reason I decided to go with Uxie in this draft is, for one, of course, like I said, ground immunity, stealth rocker. But what he offers me is green support plus memento. And with the insane setup options I have, I already mentioned, with Zygarde and Volcarona mainly, but other mods as well, Decidueye, Neolego, all this fun stuff. Having a screen setter with Memento just guarantee like setup for you is so strong. It's so insanely strong. We all know like how menacing Volcarona and Zygarde are in like on its own versus drafts. But if I get like the free setup and the screen stay for a few turns, I promise. At this point, I will promise. I mean, I have a few games to test it out. Like I said, we are 20 people in the league, so I will have a good amount of matches. But I will promise at this point, in one of those matches, I will sweep my opponent due to Uxie with screens and Memento, and then either Volcarona or Zygarde or someone else taking a Senac move and then winning the game from there. I will promise right here. It's gonna happen. And Uxie is gonna allow that, and that's why this is a super nice pick this late in the draft, which offers me quite a lot, honestly, for being my third to last mon. Or my second to last mon? At this point, I only have 10 points left. I think it's actually my second to last one. I already get one more mon. And, yeah, looking at the last one I get, it is Hitmonlee. Yeah, like I said, I don't get normal type, sadly. Didn't really fit my point budget, or I could have done it if I would have preferred other mons. But I do want the fighting type, and especially what I wanted was a rapid spinner. So that's what Hitmonlee supports me, because like I said, with Skarmory and Nidalego and Uxie, I have the option to hazard stack my opponent. And obviously, if you hazard stack, you don't want to defog, because you want hazards to stay, so I did want to have the option for rapid spin. And Hitmonlee is a nice fighting type as well. Pretty strong with either close combat or high jump kick. High jump kick, of course, being reckless boosted as well. Has the normal gem fake out shenanigans going on with Unburden, so I can sweep some stuff. But, yeah, that is in total my draft then. BSI got Sylveon, Skarmory, Gastrodon, Volcarona, Nidalego, Decidueye, Jolteon, Person, Alola, Axion, Hitmonlee. That was quite fast. The whole draft in general, like only 20 minutes, I think that's for draftiness for me, that's quite fast. But yeah, it is kind of improvised. I'm uploading this the same day I'm recording this because, yeah, I did have an exam just a few hours ago and I didn't have time to really record much stuff or team build shenanigans before that. So I will do all of that now. But yeah, let me of course know in the comments what you think about the team. Of course, give me ideas for nicknames. Mainly, give me an anime to base all these names on, because that's what I do these past days, like just choose an anime and then name all of them after characters in that anime, because that makes naming pretty easy. And I'm a big weeb, I like anime, so I'm gonna name my mons after them. But yeah, leave your suggestions in the comments, and yeah, that's all from me. If you did enjoy the video, of course leave a like, comment, subscribe, you know the deal. Hit me up on Twitter or Facebook, all the links in the description, and I will see you next time. Ciao!